The whole country now is in the grip of a very growing and expanding recession. And the government, the kind of measures that the government is taking in the name of fighting this recession, I'm afraid that these measures will only deepen the recession. Because this recession is not because of any global recession. This recession is not because there is some kind of a glut in production. This recession is because of a shortage of demand. And people, there is less demand in the market because the people have less purchasing power. So the only way to fight out this recession, to lift the country out of the mire of this recession, is to raise the purchasing power of the common people. But instead of this, the government is now giving corporate tax exemption. Yesterday, the finance minister has announced a 10% reduction in corporate tax. There is capital gains tax, it is being scrapped. And now GST Council will also probably come out with kind of tax breaks in luxury goods. This is not going to help. What is needed is increased public expenditure, increased level of wages, increased level of welfare benefits for the common people, increased payment of assistance to the crisis-ridden farmers, and the money that the government has taken from the Reserve Bank, 1,70,000 crore. The LIC is being robbed of its money, and all this money actually is going to once again empower the banks and empower the corporates to enable them to get more loans and have bigger defaults. So this is actually a very disastrous course, and that's why we have to fight for a resolution of this economic recession, because this is not global recession. This is made in India recession. This is made by Modi recession. This recession actually began, the trajectory, what triggered the recession was the note ban and then the GST, and now we have this full-scale recession in the country. So a reversal of these measures and increased expenditure for people's welfare, increased public investment, a complete halt to privatization, increased wages, these are the demands. So five left parties, today we joined hands and we held this convention in Delhi, and we have announced a week-long program of agitation from 10th to 16th October. On 16th October, we'll be appealing to all left parties to come out with a militant action program like some Chakka Jam and across the country. And also, we'll appeal to all sections of the people to link the ongoing people's struggles. Like on 24th September, now these coal workers, they will be having a one-day strike. So our appeal will be to the entire working class and the entire common people to stand by the workers. Yesterday, Jadavpur University students were attacked by ABVP, by the BJP ministers, leaders, and even the governor of West Bengal, who played his role as some kind of a BJP leader. Now, we should all stand by these students who are under attack, from JNU to Jadavpur University. When the peasantry, they are under attack, so the workers should stand by the peasantry. So, apart from left unity, we need a bigger unity of people's struggles. And if we can link up all these struggles together, then that will create a massive momentum. Because otherwise, this government is on the one hand creating economic disaster, creating, deepening the recession. And the people who are hit by this recession, now the government wants to divide them in the name of NRC. The government wants to channelize the anger of the people, the jobless people, against the so-called Bangladeshi immigrants. Now, that is a very dangerous recipe for some kind of fascist violence in this country. So this is why I think while fighting for our economic demands, we should also try and consolidate the unity of the people and unity of the people across communities, across linguistic groups, because this government is, every moment, they are completely dividing the people in the name of language, in the name of religion, in the name of immigrants and non-immigrants. The government is dividing. Our job will have to be to unite the people and to strengthen the people's movement across the country.